Hello again, I am back, and like I said, I would be in the same outfit because I'm filming in the same day. Literally just finished the other one and starting this one because it's in the way anyway, so I might as well. This one is called The Box of Wonders, probably, I don't know. I'll have to call it that now, won't I? This box is a little pink box. I say little, it's quite big, quite disorganised too. But it's full of little knick-knacky bits that I don't want on display, but I want to keep. So, I will literally pick in this and pick something out and tell you about it. So there's not going to be any like real order to this, and it's purely going to be just this for this video, because there's so much in it and so much to talk about. So, the first thing I start off with is bags. These are all from the Harry Potter Studios. I keep all the bags. I'm that person. I'm sad like that. So we start off with this one. This is a clear bag, which I had my picture of when I was riding on the broomstick in this. Purely just that. So I kept it. I'm not going to like use them again, but they stay in here for like sentimental value. I then have these like small sized bags, and they're like paper bags. They're both the same, so I'll just show you one. It says The Making of Harry Potter, the Warner Brothers Studio Tour. And it says London, but it's not quite London. It's just outside of London. And on the back it says Harry Potter, So Long It's Been. And I think it's really cute, so I have two of these ones. The handles are inside. Little paper handles. So I've got two of them. I then have this big one, which also says The Making of Harry Potter, and then this side it says Harry's the best hope we have, trust him. Which is it's the conversation between Lupin and that Ministry of Magic dude. I can't say his name properly. When they come back from flying, and he wanted to make sure that it was actually him. So they were like the first times that I went to the studios, because what I would do is when I go into the studio tour shop first, and then look around and get the like the main things that I want, purely for the fact that if I come out and they don't have it, then I'll be like really upset, because it's like the one thing that I want. So I get it there and then take it out to the car, then come back, do the tour, and then buy some more afterwards. So that's why I have so many bags. Then the last time that we went was the opening of the Hogwarts Express thing. So they had this bag, which is the smaller one, and this is plastic. And you can now like shop on the studio tour shop like website thing. So it's got like a link to that at the bottom. But I love this because it's like really cute. So I have this one, and it's one of the pop figures from the last video. And a big bag. I have the box here on the bed, so it's easier for me to pick it up, so please just ignore it in the corner of the other thing. I'll start off with the badges, I guess, because they're like on the top. I have these badges in a box. This is like an Order of the Phoenix cover, where it's got the people, the ones who fought in the in the books they're the ones that fought, and then you've got like that on the back, and inside you've got the badges. So these are cheap badges, like they're not the best, so they have spelling mistakes on them. You have each of the houses and then the house crest in the middle, and I want you to comment any mistakes that you see. So I'll hold it there for a few seconds. Right, so let me know what mistakes you saw spelling wise. It's not good. Let's just say that. I then got these from the first time I went to the Harry Potter Studios. These are like just an array of like little badges. And I still have the price on these. These are $2.99. I got these right on the way to the checkout. And because I collect badges, I just got these. There's not really much that I can say too much about them. I then have this, which is the Golden Snitch sticker kit, although I lost the stickers. I don't know where they've gone. And this is a snitch with the wings, which you can take out to put it back in the box, but it's got like this little holder thing. So this sits on my shelf in front of my books. So like near the Pygmy Puff, but not quite from the last one. So I have this, which sits in front of the books. I then also have another sticker kit thing, but I don't have the books for it or the stickers. It's in the house somewhere, but I don't know where it is. So, and that's Hedwig in his cage. I'm going to apologise now for the state that my nails are in. I really should have like redone them, but so yeah, I have this. This also sits on the shelf for my books and the other stuff. And the next thing that I've got is this. This is also from like eBay, and I got this like as a present, but in transit some of the jewels fell out, so I don't have them. But yeah, you can't wear this because it's like a really strong metal, and like I can't fit it on my head because it doesn't like, look, it doesn't, I don't even have that like big of a head. But anyway, nobody's head is that small. And then you can't like, unless you like wear it like this, but then that looks stupid. May have just messed up my hair. But yeah, I love it. It's really cute, and it says, "Which beyond measure is a man's greatest treasure?" Which I think is quite apt for the Ravenclaw house. I'm swinging that around. But yeah, the colour is gorgeous, and I think it's really cute. The next thing that I've got is this. This is just like, just a scarf. I don't wear scarves that much, so I don't have one of the proper ones from like the studio tour, because they're like £26, and I'm like, I don't wear scarves that often, but this is like, this is alright. I'm actually making myself, I'm knitting myself a Hufflepuff scarf to wear, like when I next go. I need to hurry up and do that then. But I'm knitting it, and it looks really cute, and I'm like about halfway through, so it's not too bad. But yeah. I then have this. This was on my birthday cake that my mum made. It was a Harry Potter theme for like, it was 2 years ago. So when I was 15. So yeah, I keep this on. It's like a sew-on or a iron-on badge, but I just keep it in here. I then have, what should I show you next? I have these. These I made. They're not very good. I have the lightning bolt, and I have the snitch. These are just made up of hammer beads, so you put them on the pegs and then iron them, and then they stick together like at the back. But that's that. They're not very good, but they're cool to have. I then have these notebooks. Notebooks? Took me a second to realise what I was saying. Bookmarks. Notebooks. Bloody idiot. I'm missing one. Where's Ronald? Oh, here he is. So I have all of these. These are from Waterstones. They were about like $1.99 each. So it's like 12 pounds that I've got here, but actually I only spent 10 because I didn't buy this one. I didn't steal it. I'll explain in a second. So I have Harry, Voldemort, Hagrid, Hermione, and Ron. The reason why I have two Harrys is because at my local Waterstones they've done a Harry Potter night, and they done like a game, and my team won, so we got a free bookmark. And inside I just put this little Ravenclaw badge sticker thing because they'd done like a sorting thing, but you literally just put your hand in a bowl and picked up a piece of paper to tell you what house you were in, and then they gave you a sticker. And I got Ravenclaw. But anyway. I then got these. These are like 99p each from the Harry Potter Studios. So a rubber and then two pencils. They're just basic. I have used them, not very much. I haven't used the rubber, but I've used one of the pencils. What else can I show you? I got these. These are Harry's glasses. These were quite cheap. I don't think they were like any more than like £4. But I took them out of the pack and I kind of regret it now, because I wanted to see what they looked like on me. Awful is the answer to that question. Awful. But yeah, I had them. I also got this from the studios. This was like from the first time that I went. This is a sorting hat keyring, and then on this little piece here it says the making of Harry Potter. You can see that, it might be upside down. But yeah, I got this and it's really cute. And then I have another pin badge which says the Quidditch Captain. This is from Waterstones also. I then have Top Trumps. I don't play these very much, but they have Fred Weasley on the front, and because he is my favourite, these are the Goblet of Fire cards. So for example, Goblet of Fire, and then you've got Fred and George, you've got Arthur, Barty Crouch, Cedric Diggory, Cornelius Fudge, Draco Malfoy, who I love more to the end of the series, because I just think that black suit just suits him. Look lush. You've got like obviously the trio and like some of the dragons as well. You've got Neville, who I love because he's like, he's so cute. Love him. Dumbledore, Snape, Rita Skeeter, Victor Crumb, Barty Crouch Jr., Lord Voldemort. But yeah, Fred's still my favourite. So sad that he died. Sorry if you haven't watched them. I mean, why would you be here if you haven't watched them? But never mind. So yeah, I had these. These were from my mum's friend who gave them to me for Christmas as a Christmas present. When you go to the studios, you get on a kid's ticket, you get passports, so I have two of them. This one's not stamped, but this one is. So like the inside of it like gives like some information and stuff. This one, that I can show you some of the stamps. So there's this one. So you go to each of like the little areas and you can get the stamp done. So I think that's really cool, although they're really difficult to stamp because it's like really hard to push down. I then got these from the studios. It's each of the house's postcards. So they're like this on the other side. And these are like 99p each, so even if you don't send them, they're like really nice keepsakes to have. I then have this. This is a butterbeer cup from the studios, and I don't like the taste of butterbeer. I think it's too sharp. So like the froth on top is really nice, really sweet, but then you get to the actual drink and it just like spikes your tongue and it's like, I don't know it. It really, I don't like it. But I got this one so that I could take it. I think this was about like £4.50 or something, £5. Because then the tankard, the one that you hold, is I think it was about £6 or £7. Let me move that back. So yeah, and inside here I've got all of my jewellery bits. Let's see. Oh, there it is. Usually I have this hanging off the side, so I don't know why this is actually inside of it. But I have this bookmark, which has Deathly Hallows on it, a little owl, and then a lightning bolt. I got this as a present from my friend, who I took to Harry Potter. Oh, it's all tangled. Don't you hate that when it's just, like, tangled up? How the hell? Oh, okay. I then have these two. These are both bracelets, and they have the Deathly Hallows on them, gold or snitch, and then two owls. So I have it in white, and I have it in brown. I then have, let me try and get them out. Oh, please don't tangle. I then have this time turner. These aren't like the really expensive ones. These are like the ones that you can get off like eBay and stuff. But they're good enough. I don't need them to like turn properly. So I have two of these. This one's slightly more of a brassy colour and this one's more golden. But they're the same thing. So I have them. I then have a sorting hat necklace, which is, this one is tangled. And it's like this, don't turn around. So it's got like a little face on it. I don't wear that one too much, so that one just stays in this box. And then I have a basic Deathly Hallows necklace. And this is what the cup looks like, empty. Let me just put them back in there. Right, then. Then I got this next one, like, the other day, or like, wasn't the other day, it was 2 weeks ago for my birthday. I asked for this, and I actually got it. But this, please don't tangle. Don't you hate it when my necklaces just tangle? This is a really dainty necklace in comparison to the other ones, and it is the Niffler, like with a coin. You see, my hand looks huge. But yeah, he's like stealing the coin, and it's really small and it's really cute. Like he looks tiny. But yeah, and I saw that on Etsy, and I showed it to my mum, and she was like, "Oh yeah, it's cute." Little did I know that she actually already bought it for me, which is great. I then got these two badges when I went to the studios. I didn't get any the second time that I went because nothing was on. So the first time that I ever went was Feathers and Flights, and we got to see the owls. That just fell out my hand. We got to see the owls, and like I had a picture with Hedwig, and there was like owls in Diagon Alley, and they showed you like how they trained the owls and how they train the cats to like do what they needed to do and be where they needed to be. And then the second time that we went, the third time that we went I got this one because we went to go see Platform 9 and 3 quarters and it was quite new, so they gave us a Platform 9 and 3 quarters badge. Right. We're getting there, not too much left. I got a chocolate frog. I think I said in the last video that my mum bought me and my sister a chocolate frog, a pygmy puff and a t-shirt each the second time we went. And this is the one that I got. These do go out of date. This one ran out of date on the 16th of the 8th, 2015. So I think this one I got in like early 2015, late 2014 or something. Because 1 year we went twice in a year. And inside here, I ate the frog. It was so good. Really difficult to eat though because it's like solid chocolate. So it's like you just have to like grate away at it. I got Helga Hufflepuff, which is fine because I'm in Hufflepuff and it's a good start. Although my mum got me and my sister to choose which one we wanted. And I let my sister choose because I'm that sort of person. I let her choose and I'm like, yeah, you can choose which one you want first. Because I don't like to leave her with like whatever she wants sort of thing. Or what I don't want. So, but she ended up getting Dumbledore. Quite annoying, in all fairness. But then I had this, which is like a little printed replica. And basically what this is for my 15th birthday, my mum threw me a surprise Harry Potter party. And she put like little chocolate frogs in this. And I think it was like really cute. So, love it. So sweet. Have you guys seen that video of Eddie Redmayne where he's talking about Nala from The Lion King and he's like, look at her, she's so sweet. I just reminded myself of that. I then made this in a woodtech lesson. It's awful. Look, you can see the pin. It's like bent. It's like a little Harry Potter shadow box thing. It's awful. I could do so much better now. But we had to do that. So, I done this. I was like, I have no idea what I want to put in it. So I ended up doing a Harry Potter one. It's when I first started to like really like Harry Potter. So I was like, yeah, why not? But I used this more as like a tray than a shadow box. So I put the Harry Potter stuff like in this on top of it. But, hey-ho. I then had my wands displayed on the wall. In a picture frame, and this was like in the picture frame, and it's like a little cross stitch that it's a cross stitch that my mum made, and it's a Gryffindor one because obviously I didn't know what house I was in when she made it, but I love it. I want her to do like all the houses for me. I love it so much. But yeah, so I have a cross stitch. I then have this, which is my picture that I got when I went to the studios. This was like 2 or 3 years ago. And they give you a robe to wear when on the broomsticks. But they only give you Gryffindor, Hufflepuff or Ravenclaw. They don't give you Slytherin purely for the fact that you can't quite see it on the green screen because obviously Slytherin's green, so it messes with the green screen. Then I have this, which looks the same as the picture, but this is what we get the tickets in when we go to the Harry Potter studios. So because we order ours to get home, we got them in here, so you get like a little map of how to get there from like London. Like, my insides are really itchy because of hay fever. So I keep, like, scratching my ears and stuff. Sorry. I have this, which you give to look at your photos that they took on the broomstick. And the video that you recorded. And then you get to pick which one you want. Or you don't have to get them at all. So I've got this. I then have three different tickets. So I have Forks, Fang and Dobby, and so I have them. The tickets have gone up so much more now. These were for a child ticket, £25. Oh no, look, this one was £22.50, so this was the first time we went. This is a child ticket and it's £25.50. And now the child ticket's gone up to like £35. It's like extortionate. But yeah, so I had them. And then when you get to pay for your stuff from the shop, they chuck in a few, like, bookmarks. I keep wanting to say notebooks. They're not notebooks, they're bookmarks. And these ones are Diagon Alley from the first time we went. And then these are from the last time we went. And you get the Hogwarts Express. And then on the back of these ones, it says visit the online shop. And this one's like discover more. So I keep all of these in here so that they don't, so that I don't lose them and that they don't break. A couple of them are like used, so they're not in the greatest condition. But they just sit in here. Then I have, hold on, let me cover up my address. This, which is a acceptance letter for myself. But yeah, it has my home address on, so I won't show that. But inside, there's quite a few bits. So you get a platform 9¾ ticket. This is one way to Hogwarts. I think it's one way to Hogwarts. And then this one is a night bus ticket. They're like printed on this really cool like shiny paper. Then in here I have a letter to say that I have been accepted to Hogwarts. I then have a list of requirements that you need to bring. And then, oh, there's more. There's a magical alphabet. And a list of basic spells. Use carefully. And also in this you get a little Marauder's map painted, printed on the same shiny gold paper as the Hogwarts ticket. And then it's like a little thing inside. And you also get a map of Diagon Alley so you know where to get your supplies from. So it's got like Gringotts Bank, the robes shops, you've got stationery shop, Quidditch supplies, giant spiders, shrunken heads, poisonous candles. Okay. I've never really looked at that problem before, so that's quite interesting. So I have all of these in here. Then I have these, which I got from my aunt and uncle for my birthday. These I love and wanted for ages, but they were always too much, and now they got them for me. So these are actually the wand brushes. So these are like really heavy because they're like metal, but I'm not going to use these because I have lots of makeup brushes over there, which I can use at any time. So I'm keeping these for like collective purposes. So there's this one. There's this one. This one. This one. And this one. So you get Harry, Ron, Hermione's, and Voldemort's, and the Death Stick. If people have read the books, a Death Stick. Elder Wand, Dumbledore's Wand, whatever you want to call it. And the next thing that I got is this. This is Noble Collection. So it's a Gryffindor sword, but it's a letter opener. So it's like a tiny sword. Because I said to my mum, I was like, whenever I open letters, it like really hurts my like finger because I like rip it. So she got me a tiny sword. I love it. And it's so detailed. You'd think it was like real. So I got that. And then finally, I have this, which doesn't look like much from the outside. But this is also Noble Collection. And I got this from the Harry Potter studio, so they had to like unlock it and get me one out from like their back stock, because it was like in one of them glass cases. So this is what it looks like. And then it says Harry Potter trademarked on the bottom. And inside is actually the coins, so the wizarding money, and I love these. This was really expensive though, this cost me like £25, but it's noble collection, and how often are you going to be able to say, yeah, I got wizard money? So that's it. So that's everything that's in this box. The next video that I will be posting will be clothing and anything that I might have forgotten along the way or that I find. So yeah, that will be hopefully in a few days. I just need to make sure that I've got everything with me. I'm trying to put away at the same time, that's probably really annoying. So that's the end of this video. I hope you really enjoyed it. Please give it a like and subscribe and turn on the notifications for my channel if you want to see more. There'll be like one more Harry Potter video and then the rest will be just random stuff, whether it's actually Harry Potter hauls from where I go in June or whether it will be just other videos like what's in my bag and like room tours, because I love watching them. So if I make them for you, you might like them too. So stay tuned. Bye.